So I was approached by Melissa about a wellness initiative to get our employees involved. We focus on core values, commitment, compassion, and charity. And we dove a little bit deeper into that fourth part. Fast forward a year or so later, reconnected and said, hey, look, we have this pilot initiative. We have an urban youth swim proposal. We'd like to break down some barriers for about 60 of our youth. And those barriers can include transportation, equipment, money, access, and we'd like to give them an opportunity for basic swim skills. Are you willing to help?
We picked two urban youth community centers through the Heart of Compassion. These are at-risk youth that are always after school in the apartment complex, and they have the community center there that they go to after school.
They came to us with statistics about the number of preventable deaths as a result of drowning, and then how that number increases exponentially when you consider race, and then how that number increases even beyond that when you consider where these kids who are in urban environments.
Having the opportunity for the kids to come and get acclimated with water and actually learn how to swim, it was awesome.
One of the owners of Brighton Gardens, a home for disabled adults, had heard about the swim initiative that we were doing with FTI, and she said, I want to be a part of that. So they donated some of the towels that we used for the initiative.
They were great about opening avenues for our folks to get involved. So we were able to pack the swim bags, write notes of encouragement for the kids.
Each person that came from the company that decided to volunteer wrote a thank you handwritten note that was really special, and they put together about 60 swim bags.
The fact that the YMCA was willing to be so flexible and come to our actual office with all of the materials so we could pack it there was wonderful.
All the equipment that they needed, such as bathing suits, towels, goggles, things that our kids didn't have and don't have, and some of their parents can't afford, they were given these items. And then just the opportunity to come and just the love that was shown there.
We also partnered with Power Scholars, which is one of our YMCA programs. These are children that are at risk, and what the annual giving campaign does is provides them financial assistance to where they're able to go for the day at some of the local schools and catch up on that summer learning loss. It also provided a lot of the children the opportunity to be able to take on swim lessons. And they were able to work in the classrooms with the kids. And it was really nice to see them on the floor playing games and answering questions.
Even able to connect with them in their classrooms, build a little bit more of a one-on-one, and then of course, hoot and holler for them when they walked across the stage.
It certainly meant a lot to know that the YMCA would be willing to reach out to smaller organizations to give our kids the opportunity to learn something. The parents just loved it. They were happy to see that their kids were happy.
When the entire audience was eyes on them, watching them smile, watching their chests kind of expand a little bit, their chins kind of raise.
That was something that if the money wasn't donated, we wouldn't be able to have that opportunity to serve our youth.
It's really nice to be a company that values giving back to the community. For those 60 kids whose lives may be changed because of it, I would say that in and of itself was impactful. It makes a difference to us to impact our community. Doing good for others, you're doing good for yourself. We're all interconnected.